You know, today I want to just give you my thoughts about what I feel is one lesson, the most important skill my parents or anyone's parents should have taught us, you know. You know, we all go to school, we go to college, we read so many books, we listen to so many podcasts today and MP3s, but I'll tell you, All this is not as important as one core lesson. And that is, you know, the art and the skill of how to manage money. I know you must be like, not this topic again. Hear me out. See, we spend our whole life doing what? Spend our whole life earning money, paying our bills, putting a little savings, and then nothing. And then we have to work another month, again earn money, again pay our bills, have some savings, live a normal life. And we continue this throughout our lives. And obviously, as our ability to earn more increases, we spend more because we have more purchasing power. We try to save more if possible. And the cycle goes on. Now this goes on until one fine day, either we can't earn money or some tragedy strikes or game is over. But I'll tell you, the sad thing is, I've met so many people, so many. Because of the work that I do, what I've realized is the people who are happier are the ones who know how to manage money. You know this bullshit, no? That people give, oh, money is not everything. Whoever tells you that, no, stay away from him. He's a fucking nut job. Who tells you money is not everything, just stay away from that person. Now, I'm not trying to say money is the most important thing in the world. But money is one of the most important things, one of the many, or rather one of the few, I would say, not one of the many. Because our whole lives are dedicated to what? Earning money, right? You even go to church, the church priests ask you, come on, give Jesus money. The mosque, oh, build a masjid, donate to Allah, Allah will give you Jannah. Go to the Hindu temple, oh, they'll cover the statues with gold and money. You need money for everything. God can't manufacture money, unfortunately. He can do all the magic except money. Money you have to give him. He'll give you everything else. So imagine, that is the power of money. Now the funny thing is, the tragedy is, nobody has taught us this. Very few parents have. Although there are some parents who teach their children money management, you can count them on your fingertips. See, I'll give you one simple example. It's a very simple one. You know, sometimes I tell people, if you can donate to the channel $1, $5. You must have heard me say that. I tell people, support the channel. So I get these comments, you know, sometimes you get this comment, yeah, look, he's begging, get yourself a real job. You know, the people who are saying that, they don't know. They're ignorant. They're ignorant about either what I'm doing or about money. And I'll explain why. Those very guys who are saying, why don't you go get yourself a real job? Means he found out about this by watching my video. Now he watches it for free. He wants value-based content or entertainment for free. That he doesn't want to pay money. Okay? Now he'll not even consider factoring this content, this camera that I'm speaking, using the battery, the time that I give, the ideas that I come up with, the effort that I put to edit, video, audio, uploading, the internet, the bandwidth, all this costs me money. Now, by default, you'll say, yeah, but you're getting for views. No, we get a small this thing. But you also get entertainment, right? Okay. Now, in order to create this, I need to put time, effort, and money. This is my job. Now, there are two ways of looking at it. One is I earn more than you. One is I earn less than you. If I earn more than you, the question is then why am I asking you money? If I earn less than you, people are saying stop this and get yourself a new job. You see the conundrum, you see the problem. If that was the case, you know, you go to these 5-star hotels or Elon Musk is selling Tesla and all that. Why is he trying to sell you the product? He has enough money, right? He has to generate income. He sees a need, he fulfills. That's called a business mind, business sense. Just think if Elon Musk or the, whoever, the rich guys would say, okay, I have enough money. You don't have to take everything for free. Even Mark Zuckerberg, who gives you Facebook for free, he's taking something from you, right? So that argument is stupid. Then if you're earning less, go get yourself a real job. Yeah, that's great advice. Does that mean you're earning more? No, you're also earning less. The problem is this kind of ignorance is because of lack of financial education. You know, I'm telling you this. Today I'm 44. Next year I'll be 45. I never knew the value. We hear save every penny and all that. We hear that. But we don't experience that until you become the head of the family. Today, I have to think about my wife. I have to think of my baby. I have to think about myself. I have to earn for 3 people. Me, my wife, and my kid. I have to earn for the future of P3. I have to earn for my kid's education. I have to earn for my wife's future in case I die. Because I love my wife. I, you know, if I was selfish, I'd be like, fuck it, let her work as a cleaner or something. No. When you love someone, you want them to have a good life. And obviously, I want my kid to complete her education, have a decent life. After I die, it's not that I'm going to be looking from heaven and be sad. When you die, you die. You finish. You don't exist. So I just want to do my part of giving them the best. So when you think of so many boxes, so many piggy banks where you have to put money, no matter how much you earn, even if I earn, let's say I earn $10,000, I get a contract today, immediately the money goes, house rent, business expense, lawyer, accountant, rent, then water, electricity, then education, building the house, child's education, wife's future, my emergency fund. There are so many boxes to fill here, you know. You cannot take life for granted. See, for example, if I get a client today, I don't know when I'll get the next client. Maybe 3 days, maybe 1 week, maybe 1 month, maybe 3 months. So there are these ups and downs, you know. Like you run a restaurant, you can't expect it to be full house every day. And if you advertise, and after you advertise, you get only one guy. You advertised and you paid money, but you didn't get any return on investment. Every day is an expense, no? Every day, small money goes. I know this may sound like I'm lecturing you or nagging. But unless you have a business mindset, no? You'll not understand, you'll not appreciate, you'll not know the value of what I'm saying. You'll not believe day and night. I sleep, I eat, I get up, I think, just where will I get my next customer? How will I earn more money? And this is apart from all the other things that I think about, my video, my creative work and all that. Like I tell people, you know, the beauty or the risk of what I do is I don't know when my next meal will come. I don't know when my next customer will come. So the goal is to always ensure money is coming in some way or another. Some people have investments, some people have rent, they give their house on rent, some people have different other financial instruments. We all have our ways, you know. You know, if I could give any worthwhile piece of advice, I think I would just say that we need to educate not only ourselves, but also our future generation on the value of money. It's unfortunate that in schools they don't teach you anything related to money. But I think this should be the most important education, the value of money, how to earn money. That is why, you know, when I see these people who sell fruits, vegetables, meat in the marketplace, and I see the parent with their child, and the child is selling the chicken or selling the fish, I respect that so much, because a child is getting real life education, real education on selling, buying, on the preparation involved, even to sell fish, even to sell chicken or barbecue food or vegetables. You have to pre-plan all this. You have to negotiate with the wholesalers. You have to buy in bulk. You have to check everything. You have to clean everything. You have to present it properly. You have to keep your shop ready. You have to keep the rates ready. And you have to be ready to welcome your customers. The amount of preparation that it takes like 10 hours just to sell that moment. And this is not something an uneducated mind will know. This is not something an employee would know. This only is someone with business experience. That's why if you really want your child to grow and become something, let them struggle, starting at the lowest rung of the ladder and earning money. They'll develop the character and the skills that'll take them throughout their life, you know. Anyway, this is something I learned very late in life, and I'm still learning. I wish I knew about investments. I wish I knew about business. I wish I knew about so many other things. But now, I'm 44, I have quite a number of roles to play and responsibilities and priorities. So yeah, if there was one education that I would highly recommend for you to go for, start thinking, acting, being a businessman, and value every penny. Value every... I'm not saying become stingy. I'm not saying you go to some... No, how much last? No, don't do that. Respect that person who's selling the onions, the vegetables, the fruits, the... Give them their share. Don't deprive them of that. You earn. Earn every dollar. Learn to negotiate and fight for every penny. And you'll become a better human being. That's at least what I'm learning now at this age. Started at 36 after I became penniless on the streets. That's why today I tell people, even if you donate $1, it helps. No shame in that, because remember, you have a bank account with 1 million and you issue a check of 1 million and $1, and you write a check of 1 million, 1 million and one, and you have only 1 million balance, the check will still bounce just for that $1. And that is where you'll realize the value of every penny and dollar. Like they say, you want to earn millions, start with one penny, right? Anyway, this is what I wanted to share. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I hope these videos add value, because I share the real stuff, you know. Anyway, you guys take care. Sure.